In this video, we are going to discuss about how to write VHDL code for 4-bit even parity generator circuit using. In first case, we will discuss about data flow style of modeling. In next case, we will discuss about case statement or how to write the code using the case statement. Now, let us see what actually mean by parity generator circuit is. So, for a parity generator circuit, we need certain input bits, and depending upon whether they are following even or odd parity, parity bit is generated. So, based on the parity bit generated and our original information, a 5-bit data will be transmitted and it will be phased across the receiver. Now, here, if you observe, we have an input term as 4-bit A3, A2, A1, A0 and an even parity bit which I have written as parity. Now, if it is a 4-variable combination, it will return from 0000 up to the last combination we have 1111. Now, even parity circuit is one in which if the input combinations, the number of ones are 0, or if they are even, it is going to be 0, otherwise it is going to be 1. Ab yahan par dekh sakte hain A3, A2, A1, A0 mein the input combination ka bit hai 0, 0, 0, 0. Here, number of ones are appearing 0 times. And as number of ones are appearing 0 times, which is an even number, it is satisfying even parity condition, hence a parity bit 0 will be attached. Now, when we come across second equation or second condition, when we have input bits 0, 0, 0, 1. As per as these 4 bits are considered, we have 1 appearing only 1 time. As 1 is appearing for 1 time, which is an odd number, definitely to make it even, we are attaching a parity bit as 1. So that the total number of bits becomes 5, and here number of ones are going to be even. So depending upon how many ones are there, either a 0 or 1 bit it attached as a parity bit, and the same is carried out until the last condition 1111, where we are having number of ones as 4 times and 4 is even number, hence the parity bit is 0. So depending upon this, we will fetch an expression which becomes parity is equals to A3 XOR with A2, XOR with A1 and XOR with A0. Now we'll move on to write the code as starting with library. Use the library terms as IEEE.standardlogic1164.all. Then we'll define the entity as parity is. We'll define its port as port A, which is input standard logic vector whose length is 320. It will generate signals as A3, A2, A1, A0. And an output bit as parity, which is going to be a bit. We'll end this entity. Now we'll move on to architecture. Architecture behavioral, or even if you write this as concurrent, it will be fine. Of the entity name is parity. Then we'll initialize the statement by using begin, and we'll write the equation. Parity is equals to A3 XOR with A2 XOR with A1 XOR with A0. And finally, we'll end the architecture. So this is going to be a VHDL code using data flow style of modeling. This is quite a simple concept. Now we'll write the same code using case statement. Move on for that. Again, the first term will be same. We can keep library terms as it is. Next, using it, then entity declaration and its port. Finally, we'll end the entity. And now we'll move on to architecture behavioral of parity is. Now we'll move on to write the code as begin, and we'll write the term as process A, because it generally discriminates between the concurrent statements and our sequential statements. So process A, we'll initialize it with a statement as begin. Now we'll go for writing a statement as case. Here we are selecting A, so it is written as case A is. As far as A is considered, it is having a length 3 down to 0, so it will have a combination from 0000 up to last as 1111 that we have seen in the previous truth table. So it becomes first condition when case A is 0000. Now when this combination appears, parity bit will be 0. So we have written parity should be less than or equals to 0. Now the same instructions we have to repeat. When it is 0001, parity should be 1. Next parity is 1. But next parity is 0. Similarly, if you see from the truth table, we can obtain the terms starting from 0100. Up to the last condition we can fetch, which is 1111, the parity bit is 0. Now, if none of the condition is satisfied, that means we will write this last statement when others. The parity bit should be 0000. Now, this other condition has to be written because we are selecting A as input. Now, in many of the cases, if the user don't know about how many bits has to be declared, if it puts more than 4 bit of data, automatically it will generate an error that is called as when others. The parity is going to be undefined or 0000. And we'll write